So other things you might need to go along with your guitar are either a Plectrum or a Flatpick, sometimes they call it. I don't actually use one, and this isn't even a Plectrum, it's a piece of plastic that I've cut into the shape of a Plectrum just for the purposes of showing you what it is, how to use it, how to hold it. This is a thumb pick. Again, I rarely use it. It goes over your thumb like that and basically acts as a Plectrum or a pick. You can get finger picks as well. Personally, again, I don't like them. I don't find them comfy to use. The thing about a Plectrum is it makes a big difference how you hold the Plectrum. So just imagine this is a Plectrum. Okay, now what you don't want to do is to be holding it like that. What you really want is you've got the point of the Plectrum should be coming out of the side of your thumb. It shouldn't be coming out the top of your thumb like that or like that or whatever. It should come out sort of at right angles to your thumb. If you're holding it from this side, your finger should be running along towards the point of the Plectrum. You kind of want roughly about that sort of distance coming out the end of your thumb, and that's, I should have really tried to find a bit of black plastic, but anyway, you know, that's how it should look. Your finger, it should be an extension really of your fingernail, that finger, your first finger, and comes out right angles to your thumb. So if you're using a Plectrum, strumming with a Plectrum, what you need to do is you need to have a fairly firm grip on your Plectrum. Sometimes called a flat pick. I think Americans mostly call it a flat pick. We call it a Plectrum. It doesn't matter what you call it, it's a pick. And you need a fairly firm grip on it. If you hold it too near to the fat end, or you hold it too loose, you'll get that kind of sound. It's like if you, when you were a kid, when you taped a bit of plastic onto your, the back of your bike frame and had it on your spokes, so you'll have that kind of sound going on. You don't want that kind of sound, so you want to be holding it sort of halfway up the Plectrum, fairly firmly. You don't want the Plectrum to be moving around, it needs to be fairly firm. So you're holding it like that, and you get a nice clean sound. If you hold it at the end or too loose, you'll get a really weak sound. And if you can hear that, you can hear that almost as loud as the strings. You don't want that. Hold it about halfway up the Plectrum and, you know, keep a fair grip on it. Thumb pick, as I mentioned before, they come in different sizes, so if, you know, if the shop's got a few, try a few on. You don't want one that's, you know, really grabbing your thumb, but you don't want one that's too loose. And as I say, with just a tiny bit of heat, you know, I just put just a bit of heat for maybe a second or two on it, and I just eased it out. And did it a couple of times until I took enough of the pressure off from the thumb. But even then, if I'm playing that, using that for a while, it's just uncomfy for me. So I don't really use it very often at all. So I tend to just use my thumb and the nails. If you're using your nails, they have to be, you know, reasonably long, not too long. If they're too long, they'll tend to be easier to break for a start. It's personal preference really. My nails are that long. My thumbnail is that long. It's quite long. If I let them get just too long, if I let them get way too long, as I say, they start to chip and they start to break and whatnot, and then it's a real pain because you have to wait on them growing out until you can get the sound you want again. I've also seen people using false nails. Never tried them myself. I think it's a pretty good idea. One of these days I might do. I might actually bite the bullet and go try and get a set and try them out. I just don't like the thought of them coming off in your mouth. Sometimes I kind of really bash my guitar if I'm, you know, doing it. I'm not sure how these false nails, you know, you always get these sort of gillies going, ooh, I've lost a nail, whatever, and I don't want to really be losing a nail, especially if the nail, if I've cut the nails underneath. So I've got a short nail and I've just put sort of plastic nails on. So that's how I keep my nails, and that's what I use.